In this video, Scott will be referencing to a video that will be in the description below.
West Hill United is a progressive spiritual community where how you live is more important than what you believe. West Hill United is a people, a place, an idea. We are a community living out of a progressive faith, striving to make a positive difference in our own lives, the lives of others, and the world. Join us Sundays at 10:30 a.m. or connect with us at any time.
Dick Van Dyke. If you ever get a chance to see him speaking about his life, and his life with alcoholism, it's really worth listening to. Really very powerful, very strong, very measured and centered and grounded in the things we don't know. Mary Poppins was one of the first places people saw Dick Van Dyke, and he says this about the songs in that movie. Those songs, the Mary Poppins songs, didn't just get under my skin. They became a part of me then and there. And thinking about it now, they've never left me. You know what he means by that? That a song has never left you. It stays with you. Name a song from Mary Poppins. Oh, they've all left you, evidently. Supercalifragilisticexpialidocious, and one of my favorites is Feed the Birds, Tuppence a Bag. That's a beautiful song. Chim Chim Cheree, very good. Just a Spoonful of Sugar helps the medicine go down. And I love the song that the mum sings about sister suffragettes. Do you remember? Though we adore men individually, we agree that as a group, they're rather stupid. This is the thing about songs. They are shooting stars that can take you back in time. Do you remember a song that you heard first time a long time ago? They can take you back. They can take you back to a place that's good. They can take you back to a place that's hard. They can take you back. They can also go forward with you. Some songs can get us through the day, the week, the month, the years, and right into all our ages. It was sent by someone named Rena Doss. The first reading, Ruth is going to be reading during the time, that's why I wanted to give her less room, you know, distance to walk. So the first reading is by a fellow that gives sort of self-help, motivational speaking. He comes from a hard life and brings his wisdom to that. And so I'll ask Ruth to give the first reading.
This reading is from the life and business coach and author, Rashid Oganlaru. His writing has appeared on the BBC, The Times, and The Guardian, and his original songs include Music Saved My Life. We love music deeply, but why? Put simply, music makes lives, shapes lives, expresses all shades and stages of life, and even sometimes saves lives.
There's so many things to talk about music, so many ways it impacts our life, and I just want to leave you with four that you'll see it in these songs, and hopefully you carry it out with you to say, music can move me in these four areas. Number one, and you know these, there are protest songs, songs that march, songs that object to things, songs that say, no more of this. We'll look at that for a moment or two. And then there's songs that say, in your own personal life, I'll be with you, I'll be there with you, I'll support you, I'll stand by you. And there's songs that stand by me, there's many songs come to mind under that. And you might wonder why I've chosen some of the ones I've chosen, because you could take these themes and maybe choose completely different songs and they would speak to you. And then there's songs that when you're feeling low and the task ahead of you is difficult and you need encouragement, there's songs that just put the blood running in you and help you move forward. And then there's songs that inspire you to take action in an area that you've just realized is hurting and needing people, and you're not feeling brave enough to do that, and you are inspired to act for other people. So those are just the four areas, but I'm going to ask if anyone here, now I'm going to ask Dan to come up, if you could quickly, and share. Dan responded to the call to share a favorite song, and he's going to come up and just tell you about his.
Thank you. There are many I could say, actually, but one that I loved when I learned it from Quakers is How Can I Keep From Singing? And it's got some sort of somewhat explicitly religious words, but I interpret them very non-theistically. Like, there's a line, since love is Lord of heaven and earth, how can I keep from singing? And it's about love. That's the important thing. It's not about heaven. So, yeah. And it's just one of those inspiring spiritual things.
And I know a few things about Dan, but I didn't know he sang. And so we're going to have him back someday and sing with us, which would be very lovely. David sent this to me. A song from a particular part in his past, his training as a choir boy and later as an organist at a cathedral. He can still remember all the words. Can you remember all? I can't remember all the words to a song. But for as a modern man, I'm just reading what he sent. I hearken back to Victorian times where that period was somewhat consumed with beauty and nature. If I had to pick a composer that, among others, really speaks to me, it would be... You would put something different here, perhaps. Herbert Howells. I went and looked him up. Where other church musicians in the time of belief started with church music, often went on to compose symphonies and operas, Howells stuck with music for the church. And he wrote songs that called Mine Eyes for Beauty Pine. Do not like Mine Eyes for Beauty Pine. Like as the heart, which is a deer, desireth the water brooks, and love doth stand at hand, joy doth will, while on command, wait on command. I love all beauteous things, I seek and adore them, there is no better praise. I too will something make, a joy in the making, and tomorrow it seemed like the empty words of a dream remembered on waking. Thank you, David, for sending that. So, next slide, please. Just next, there we go. Do you know who that is? That's Marvin Gaye. Marvin Gaye had one heck of a rough road with substance abuse, with relationship difficulties, and he wrote a song, and you would remember it, called What's Going On? And it's, if you want to, I'm really recommending some of these. Get on YouTube, watch the YouTube about that, about what was going on in the 60s, a turbulent time. The next I want you to listen to is another one, a protest. And his name is Sam Cooke, and he wrote and sang the song, A Change Is Going to Come. It's a protest song, and the pictures are really worth looking to, so I'm going to ask the tech team to put that video on.
It's been a long time coming, but I know a change gonna come. Oh, yes, it will. It's been too hard living, but I'm afraid to die. 'Cause I don't know what's up there beyond the sky. It's been a long time coming, but I know a change gonna come. Somebody keep telling me don't hang around. It's been a long time coming, but I know a change gonna come. Oh, yes, it will. Then I go to my brother. And I say, brother, help me please. But he winds up knocking me back down on my knees. Oh, there've been times that I thought I could last for long.
There's like, one simple hearing hack.
I like the closed captioning at the end there for people who are just watching. It says uplifting music. I like that idea to cue that. That's a song of hope, but I'm sure you saw some of those scenes and we haven't fixed them yet, so we have to keep with that. So that's protest songs. And it kind of blends in with the next idea, the encouragement. W.E.B. Du Bois, black writer, wrote The Souls of Black Folk. The Souls of Black Folk. He wrote this. Through all the sorrow of the sorrow songs, there breathes a hope, a faith in the ultimate justice of things. The minor cadences and chords of despair change often to triumph and calm confidence. Sometimes it's faith in life, sometimes a faith in the boundless justice. But whichever it is, the meaning is always clear that sometimes, somewhere, people will judge people by their souls and not by their skins. Is such a hope justified? Do the sorrow songs sing true? David Bowie. Next slide shows David Bowie. And whatever your familiarity with his music is, he was a struggling artist for a very, very long time. Took a long time to find his, he called it his groove. But then many of his songs struck out on social justice issues, on racial issues, and very provocative. Some people weren't allowed to listen to David Bowie's songs. I was one of them when I was young, but I do now. But the Changes, he wrote the song Changes, and if you want to look that one up at home, David Bowie, Changes, very powerful song. We're going to sing one, Greta wrote this, called Keep Wide Your Heart, and hopefully it's a song that encourages us to hang in there with the challenges.
Since we're going to be singing so much today, if you want to stand, stand. If you want to sit, sit.
Support. The next slide shows a boy band, a British boy band, and they are called Union J. And it took me, could we have the slide of the group? There they are. Aren't they good? I'd never heard of them, but and it took me a long time before I actually clued into the fact that Union J stood for Union Jack, British band. And they have sung a song called I'll Carry You. And it's one of the songs that repeats a lot. It's kind of a dance tune, but the repeated refrain keeps saying, when the vision you have gets blurry, you don't have to worry, I'll be your eyes. It's the least I can do. 'Cause when I fell, you pulled me through. So you'll know that I'll carry you. And if you've ever had someone stand beside you in a difficult time, and support you and encourage you, then you know what that would be. Because when I fell, you pulled me through. I have fallen, and I have been befriended by people that stood beside me in that. And as you look back in your life, you may have had that. Or you remember a time when you deeply wished someone would be there, someone to understand, maybe even someone you didn't have to tell the whole thing to, but you just wanted them to be there with you. So Union Jack, look that one up. It's a good, happy song, but it's, don't ever say you're all alone. Lay your problems on me, and I'll be waiting there for you. The stars can be so blinding. When you get tired of fighting, you know the one you can look to. I'll carry you. Great song. Never heard of it before, but I liked finding out about it. And then there's a reading from someone, again, I never heard of. I love meeting these people I never heard of, and they've got something so rich to share with us. So Ruth, second reading.
This reading is from the work of Sandra McCracken, a singer-songwriter who draws on folk gospel and traditional hymns. Sandra founded an artist collective in Nashville and co-founded a children's music collective. The following is from her book, Send Out Your Light. If we sing songs with thin ideas, superficial hopes, and more hype than authenticity, we will find ourselves depleted in times when we need some truth to fall back on. We need songs sturdy enough to sing at the bedside of a dying friend. We need songs of comfort for the birth of a child. We need songs that we can share that inform our hearts and minds of what is true for the times when we can't think true things for ourselves.
The singer-actor Judy Collins once commented that she liked Canadian-written songs because they told the truth. Canadian, sorry for everyone who's not a Canadian, but I'm sure your country tells the truth as well. These Canadian artists tell the truth. Tim McGraw, country western star. In the next slide shows the cover of his album, and it's called Always Be Humble and Kind. Beautiful song, beautifully sung. Look it up. Always be humble and kind. Humble prevents us from showing kindness in a patronizing way. Humble is, I'm with you because I'm one of you, and we're together because we're the same. That's Tim McGraw. I'm going to ask Donna to bring a solo written by Reba. It's called I Will. I'll be. It will be called I Be. That's why I asked them to sit close beside you. Done.
Just about to get I Will out of here and put I Be.
Falls upon your heart and soul. I'll be the light that shines for you. When you forget about.
I'm sorry, can we start again, Scott? Let's do that. That's great. Nerves. And when
Someone to see you through. I'll be there to carry you. I'll be there. I'll be the rock that will be strong for you, one that will hold on to you when you feel the rain falling down. When there's nobody else around, I'll be the sun. When your heart's filled with rain, I'll be the one to chase the rain away. Be your shoulder when you need someone to lean on. Be your shelter when you need someone to see you through. I'll be there to carry you. I'll be there. A rock that will be strong for you. One that will hold on to you when you feel the rain falling down. When there's nobody else around, I'll be. I'll be.
Big song, sung with heart and soul. Thank you, Donna. It's a pure privilege to accompany. Privilege makes one humble. The next picture, Big Sean and his mum. Big Sean and his mum. This is a singer. It's a style I wasn't familiar with as well. And his music career went on, and nobody knew he was battling depression, heavy depression. And his mom and he started a couple of programs to help people with depression that would never admit it, would never. And so that seeing Sean, if that was your hero, Big Sean, has been through this. And I don't know how many times, you know, we've experienced it here, that someone will speak about something they're going through, and someone will also come and say, I thought I was the only one that was going through that. And depression is such a hidden thing. People can look so fine that unless you knew them really, really well, you couldn't tell that they were off or just under or whatever. And so for Big Sean and his mom, and they've spoken all over the states in different places, and he wrote a song called One Man Can Change the World. And the theme of that song, that's another one to look up, One Man Can Change the World by Big Sean. And he talks about, you may want all the things in the world, you may have all the things in the world, but don't forget, one man can change the world, so decide which way you want to go with that, because you will change the world in some way. It's a powerful, powerful song. Big Sean and his mum. I have a video to show you, and I debated just the words showing, because they're so simple. This could be sung for children, but it wasn't written for children. And it's sung by a man named Jacobs who wrote a song to say how right there and available the help we can give can be sometimes. And the song is called My Own Two Hands. And because the lyrics will be on the screen, and because it's so deceptively simple, I'm inviting us to sing along with it as you see it. And I hope that your two hands tingle nicely today and the rest of the week and the rest of the month, realizing that he has encouraged you to use your own two hands to make a difference. So the video for With My Own Two Hands. Oh, that doesn't sound like the right one, does it? Could you stop that one? I'm sorry. Could you stop that one? Very good, thank you. Did I do that wrong? If I did, bear with me one moment. Okay, well, the one I was going for was My Two Hands. Is that not the next one on the list? Was that the one? Oh, okay.
I can change the world with my own two hands, make it a better place with my own two hands, make it a kinder place with my own two hands, with my own, with my own two hands. I can make peace on earth with my own two hands. I can clean up the earth with my own two hands. I can reach out to you with my own two hands, with my own, with my own two hands, with my own, with my own. I'm gonna make it a brighter place with my own two hands. I'm gonna make it a safer place with my own two hands. I'm gonna help the human race with my own two hands, with my own, with my own. I can comfort you with my own two hands, but you got to use your own two hands, use your own, use your own two hands, use your own, use your own.
Sometimes a simple song like a jingle or an advertisement sticks with you and annoys you. I hope that one sticks with you and prompts your two hands to do something beautiful for someone. And songs can inspire us to act in ways that gather the protest and the support and the encouragement together and help us move into areas. I know there's many people here that say, I never would have dreamt I would have get involved in that subject area or that issue or that whatever, but I did, and I found a new meaning in that. I'm gonna ask Ruth to bring us the third reading.
This is from the work of Joy Harjo, a teacher, poet, saxophonist, actress, band member, playwright, and vocalist from Oklahoma, and a member of the Muscogee Creek Nation. She earned a BA from the University of New Mexico and a master's in fine arts from the Iowa Writers Group Workshop. She has served as professor and chair of excellence in creative writing at the University of Tennessee and has taught creative writing at several universities. Harjo is a founding board member of the Native Arts and Cultures Foundation, and she was named U.S. Poet Laureate in June of 2019. In her creative work, which is often autobiographical, Harjo draws on First Nations storytelling and histories, as well as feminist and social justice poetic traditions, and frequently incorporates Indigenous myths, symbols, and values into her writing. Her poetry is set in the landscape of the American Southwest and Southeast, and also Alaska and Hawaii. She has released 4 albums of original music. She shares her deep concern with politics, tradition, remembrance, and the transformational aspects of poetry. The following is from her book, Catching the Light. We must take care to feed the minds, hearts, and spirits of those coming up behind us, to offer songs, poems, and stories that will break open that which is hardened, expose that which is evil-minded or would harm, and remind us how we are constructed to bring forth beauty in thought and beingness. Offered as wisdom for the journey, may we walk,
in its light.
The group Pentatonix sings a cappella in gorgeously rich harmony, including the percussion. It's just them, there's no instruments at all. They have done a rendition of a song very familiar, I can almost guarantee, very familiar. But the way they perform this one is inspiring to act on the issues that come forward in the song. So I'm gonna ask again to the tech team, and this one just ends, as I've indicated, at 4:58, I believe, 4:58. It'll seem a bit cut off, but there's credits that roll after that. So I'm going to invite you to be inspired by Pentatonix's version of John Lennon's Imagine. Whew. I love the way they passed their identity to the next one who took it. I just love the way they patterned that out. Inspiring. The world sang out all its songs to me, but yet I'm not satisfied. I want to hear more. I want to hear your song. Your song. And all these songs can be our songs. Songs of protest, songs of support, songs of encouragement, and songs that inspire us to act. Susie Kasam, I've bumped into her writings from time to time. She wrote, Rise Up and Salute the Sun. And she said this, you are a valuable instrument in the orchestration of your own world. Let's say it again. You are a valuable instrument in the orchestration of your own world. So always be in command of your music, of your song. Only you can control and shape its tone. If life throws you a few bad notes or vibrations, don't let them interrupt or alter your song. Now, I'm going to ask you just as a favor to me, because I love this song, and it's such an old chestnut. But this is done by a group that came together, and it's called Broadway for Orlando, if you remember the shooting and the LGBT issues that went on with that. So this is a group, and they each take a little part of it, which I thought was so good about, we all have our own song. So if we could have the song, I won't tell you what it is till it comes on, but you know it well. But this is a group of Hollywood stars singing for Orlando.
That there's just too little love, but the world. for some, but for everyone.
No, we don't need another mountain. There are mountains and hillsides enough to climb.
There are oceans and rivers
enough to cross, enough to last,
enough to last till the end of time.
What the world needs now is love, sweet love. It's the only thing that there's just too little of.
What the world needs now is love, sweet love.
No, not just for some.
The meadow. There are cornfields and wheat fields enough to grow.
There are sunbeams and moonbeams enough to shine.
Oh, listen, Lord.
If you want to know.
If you want to know.
But for everyone,
what the world needs now is love, sweet love.
What the world needs now is love, sweet love.
Such a familiar song, but such a powerful message, and they repeat it. You saw and you heard a number of singing styles in that. Some you're familiar with, some are a little different, and there was different ages and different. I love that. And tech team, thank you. I've switched things around just a little bit, and I'm going to ask us now if you would go to the very last song on the slide program, and Babette, if you sing the very last one. So songs of protest, songs of support, songs of encouragement, and songs that inspire us to act. We've heard them, we've sung some of them, and then they can become our song. So what will you protest? What are you protesting that really should be protested? What are you objecting to? What are you putting your song, your voice to? And support, is there someone that needs your support? Do you need support? And we need to know that. Do you know someone that just wants someone to stand beside them? And maybe it's getting a little fatiguing doing that over and over, and yet we can still do that, sing that song to them. And then the encouragement, if someone is very low or going through a time that's not going to be fixed very soon, to be with that person. And then a song that will inspire you to speak out in your workplace, in your home, in your neighborhood. Sometimes the home part is the hardest part. If people in your home see things differently, or people in your wider family see things differently, but I hope our songs, the songs of our life, can be filled with protest where it should be, and inspiration and comfort and encouragement. And the final song Babette will lead us with is May We Be One.
Become a sustaining champion of West Hill United's work by committing to an automatic monthly donation. Learn more or donate now through Canada Helps.